I'm on an aeroplane, and the destination of this flight is to the other side. Guess I had to go there, guess I had to come here, yeah. I know where I'm from, but now I'm headed where I'm going, right? But there are powers in the air, you can't see them. And they have rockets and machine guns, and they're firing on my plane. But I say fire! Straight cause it's sideways, trying to take water to a dry place, trying to take hope where it ain't night, trying to take love.
And I want to encourage you today that don't let your circumstances keep you from pursuing where God is about to take you. This event is called Purpose Seekers, and we're about to go to a whole nother level, to some dimension. And I'm telling you, if you came today and you feel like giving up, you're in the right place. If you came today and you feel like throwing in the towel, you're in the right place. If you came today and you feel like hiding the rock, you are in the right place. Hiding and just shedding away, nobody bother me, you are in the right place. If you came today and you feel like, God, I don't think who you created is the right person. I think you made an accident when you created me. And I'm telling you, several people feel like that. And I felt like that at one point in my life. Because you feel like everything I touch is not succeeding. But you're in the right place today because it's launching season. It's time for you to be launched and pushed to your next dimension where God's about to take you. So God began to take me through a season of frustration to push me out of my comfort zone. So if you in a season of frustration, get ready because God's about to push you and launch you out into what he wants you to be. I was telling God, I want a career. I want to, you know, I want to work in the office. I want this. I want a set income. This and that. He said, well, I'm taking you as far greater than what you're asking for. And I didn't want to obey him. And he had to let me go through frustration. Today is your day that God is about to change your name. I'm telling you, some of you all, God is about to give you a, you ever hear somebody say, let me reintroduce myself? You're going to walk out of here today saying, let me reintroduce myself. I once was in fear, but now I'm walking in faith. I once was the person that let everybody control my thoughts, but now I don't care what you feel because I'm hearing what the Father is telling me. Because he says, I'm ordering your footsteps. And that's what he's going to do for you today. He's going to order your footsteps. He's going to order your divine footsteps. Because let me tell you something. The only reason God took me through what he took me through, because he told me there's going to be other ones going through the same thing you're going through. And all you were doing was being a yielded vessel. And you're being used by God to help somebody else out. And guess what? Once you help somebody else out, now is the opportunity to help somebody else out. It is a thing.
The possibilities, the thing that you never even thought of.
And I was told that my position had been eliminated. And so, of course, you can imagine how I felt at that moment. And so the tears kind of welled up in my eyes. And I asked God, I said, please let me leave this building today the same way I came in here with my head held high. And so literally they told me that I needed to vacate the building within the hour. So I left that office, went back to my office, brought my team together, explained what happened, and asked them to help me get my things together. I was one of those that I lived in my office. And so we had to get some boxes and packed up everything. And so sure enough, got everything in the car, and as I was leaving the campus, the tears came. And so I thanked God at that moment, though, that I was able to leave the way I came in. So that was on a Thursday. So needless to say, I cried all day Thursday. I was so upset. I was shocked. This was my dream job. I couldn't imagine why this happened to me. And I thank God that he placed an angel. A couple of my girlfriends, they checked on me that day. And one girlfriend in particular reached out to me about 11:45 p.m. that night. And she said, are you still crying? I said, yeah. She said, well, I tell you what, we're going to talk on the phone for another 12 minutes. And with 3 minutes left, because there's something about the number three, we are going to focus on your future. And at 12 midnight, it is a new day.
Yeah.
And I said, but this just happened to me today. I need more time to process it. And she said, not with the assignment that God has on your life. You don't have time to deal with pity.
Oh,
and so literally at midnight, I started singing songs of praise, went to sleep that Saturday, that Friday got up, put a little strategy together. That Saturday I went shopping. I love to shop, but instead of clothes shopping, I went furniture shopping. That Sunday, I went back to the very church that had downsized me. Everybody was talking. There were six of us, actually, that had been downsized. So rumored, you know, all the gossip meals, that they had gone full-fledged. Y'all wore the baddest outfit I had that day. I showed up sugar shop, right? I went in there with my head held high. I went to both services. I wanted to make sure everybody that wanted to know what I was looking like and how I was feeling, they could see for themselves. And so I went both services that Monday morning, got up, went down to the state of Georgia and filed my paperwork. And that's been 13 years ago that I launched the Wear Agency. So I have been a full time entrepreneur for 13 years. Now let me be honest with you. Again, I didn't have any notice. So I didn't have a plan. I didn't have any money. And I didn't have an MRS degree.
So I knew I didn't have a ram in the bush. And so all I had was my faith. And so what I'm going to be sharing today is literally a part of my 13-year journey. I like to be very, very transparent because I don't want you to think that an overnight success exists. My overnight success took 7 years. So of my 13 years, the first seven, I didn't know what I was doing. Now, God was faithful. I owned my home. I had a rental property and cars, and I was able to get contracts, and I was able to keep the wheels turning, but I wasn't comfortable. I was just working. And so I connected with a coach, and that coach really helped me kind of figure out where I was going. And that is what led to the last 6 years of my journey, really turning around my business.
Make it straight cause it's sideways. Tryna take water to a dry place. Tryna take hope where it ain't night. Tryna take low to a high place. Wanna make the shooter put the gun down. So a mother gets to hold the sun now. Wanna make the lame man run again. Make the blind man see the sun again. But all I hear is bang, bang, gag, gag. I don't think the pods really want that. Breathe it out my neck, always in my back. Got the guns out but I see fire. The destination of this rocket is to outer space.
Hi, my name is Adrian Haynes. I came today to the Purpose Seekers Conference Summit Brunch, and I had an amazing time. Learned a lot of information, awesome women networking. It was just amazing. I learned a lot today. Robin Ware is the person to go to, and you want to get to know Jackie Flemming. So whatever you do, reach out to her, find out the information, and be here next time. Purpose Seekers has your answer. If you're looking for an answer, Purpose Seekers is where you want to come.
Hi, my name is Sharita Austin, and I was so honored to be a part of the Purpose Seekers brunch on today. It was life-changing. It was awesome. It was thought-provoking. It have me now thinking that I want to seek more of what my purpose is and live a life on purpose. Awesome, awesome, awesome event.
Hi everyone, I'm Sharonda Dallas, makeup artist to the stars. I'm here at Jackie Flemming's Purpose Seekers event. When I tell you, it was wonderful. It was one of the best events I've ever been to in my life, and I've been a lot of places. Make sure you check her out and buy her book. It's awesome. It's life-changing.
Hello, my name is Tangela, and I enjoyed the Power Seekers today. It was an awesome event. It allowed me to think passionately about what it is that I'm trying to do for my life, and as well as where God is taking me. It was a blessing. It's a blessing to be here. It's a blessing to meet all the ladies that came out today. I just want to be able to take what I've learned here and apply it to my business, my clientele, and possibly be able to roll it further with my ministry.
I'm Kareem Amadi, and I was a guest here at the Purpose Seekers Conference. I want to say it was awesome. It was wonderful. It was very thought-provoking and inspiring. The speakers were top of the line from beginning to end. I enjoyed myself. I learned a lot, and I hope to impart some of what I have learned with others.
My name is Shonda Davis, and today has been a life-changing moment for me. I attended the Purpose Seekers Empowerment Brunch and received some valuable information from Barbara Ware. I plan to utilize every method that I was given to become a successful business.
Wonderful event. I really enjoyed it. To God be the glory. Very inspiring, very empowering, very uplifting, and definitely a great way to start the new year, because You know, God has blessed us to get into a new year, so we have to realize that we're still here, we're on purpose, and God has got great plans for all of us. It was a wonderful event. The speakers were awesome. It definitely fed my mind and my spirit, and definitely I know we'll be moving on from here with a different mindset, a new vision, a new encouragement, and a new strength. And I want to just thank Lady Jackie for being obedient and sticking to her vision and her dream. And I hope that God will bless her to keep pressing and to keep moving on, empowering women and doing the work He has called me to do. So well done, and it was wonderful to be here with you.
And there are powers, even there, but you can see them. They have